Now, guess where am I now? Okay, I'm at my old secondary school, Montfort Secondary School. And I'm here to meet the Heritage Secretary of Montfort, who is going to walk me down the memory lane of what Montfort was before. Yes, I know, I was from Montfort once upon a time. No, I've went through the history, the experience, the lovely friends that I've had with here. But you know, there are things that I don't even know that Montfort was once upon a time a place for the brothers. So we're going to meet a friend. We're going to meet a friend who's going to tell us about the history of Montfort, and his name is Bernard Yu.
Projects and the Montfort alumni. Welcome to the refurbished Heritage Gallery of Montfort School. It is a school with a rich heritage founded in 1916. Okay, so Montfort School was first founded by the Parish Church, which is the Church of the Blessed Virgin Mary of the, Nativity Church. It is still situated at Upper Serangoon Road. The school was founded there by the church as Holy Innocents English School, and due to the strong enrollment of the school and the strong reputation of the school, the enrollment of the school increased significantly to the point that the church could not cope. So they wrote a letter to the Brothers of St. Gabriel based in Bangkok at the time to say, can you help to take over Montfort School? Because basically we could not everyone, and Brother St. Gabriel agreed. They arrived in Singapore in 1936 to take over Montfort School, which at that time was still known as Holy Innocents English School. So in case you have realized, hey, why Holy Innocents English School? There was a road near the old Montfort School known as Holy Innocents Lane, and that is how Holy Innocents High and Holy Innocents English School got its name. So both Holy Innocents High and Holy Innocents English School were both founded by the church. But after Brothers of St. Gabriel came over and took over in 1936, Montfort School has since been under the management of Brothers of St. Gabriel even to this day. So this is the first part of the Heritage Gallery where we showcase the contribution of the Brothers of St. Gabriel, who selflessly gave up all worldly goods to contribute to education. So they believe that education is the way to get out of a life of poverty. Okay. So in those days when St. Montfort School was founded, the church, the priest of the church, and then later on the brothers, they actually go to the villages, the kampongs, door to door, and basically persuaded the families to send their sons to school. Ever wonder how Holy Innocents got its name? That was the old name of the Montfort School, Holy Innocents English School. So the old Hougang people know that besides the old Montfort School, which is next to the Nativity Church, there used to be a plot of a Catholic cemetery for the Hougang people, you might recall. There was a small road there known as the Holy Innocents Lane. In fact, we have ex-students and teachers who live along Holy Innocents Lane. So why is it called Holy Innocents? Okay, so the story goes like this. Firstly, the church land at the time was owned by the Catholic Church, so which is why you get the naming rights for the road. So in the story goes like this. In the Bible, there is this in the Gospel of Matthew, there is this story called the Massacre of the Innocents. So what happened? Herod the king, today you will call him Kiasu, in order to protect his throne, he killed all the young male children so that his throne is protected. So these young children who died early, they were massacred. They were called the Holy Innocents, which is why there is this feast day known as the Feast Day of the Holy Innocents. So that's how Montfort School got its own name. It's still around next to the church. They call it the greenhouse. Some of the Catholics over there, they nicknamed it because it used to be green color. So this is where when Holy Innocents English School was founded in 1916, a class was started in this building. Right. So that was the original building that is still preserved. Today this school is with the Our Lady of the Nativity.
Okay, which one was built first? Was it the church or the church, green building?
Church. Okay, this one I don't know when, but basically I will just say that this church has 150 years history, you know. Then when the school wanted to start a school, they start out with this glass in this building first. Then after that, when the enrollment increased, they start to build story by story, block by block, to the state of what the old Northern School was. That it became into a complex. So every extension was being built, and there was one year that we managed to invite the Sultan of Johor to come and officiate the opening. And do you know that he also made a donation for the school, because he believes that it's for good cause, education is for everyone, because Mongol school, even though it's protected, it educates everyone, including Malays and Muslims. And there was a Virgin Mary statue over here, and do you know that the Sultan of Johor is the one who donated money to build this statue that still stands today. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier on, the enrollment in the Montfort School increased to such a great extent that the church could not build it. So they invited the Brothers of St. Gabriel to come to Singapore to take over the management of the school, and eventually they raised funds progressively from the community, from benefactors to expand the ground. So this is the original building next to the church, which is still around. The first class was there. Then after that, they will start to build the additional block story by story to this current state, which all the old boys up to the 80s and 90s will end up. School. So Montfort at the time, we are the only school with a band. So the band performed for LKY that day. Old Boy and the MP for Punggol. This part is the Nativity Church that still stands today at Upper Sulaiman Road, right near to the Punggol Park. So as I mentioned earlier on, due to the increasing enrollment, the school has to be, the complex has to be expanded progressively. So in 1948, Sultan of Johor came to Singapore to officiate the opening of a second floor of a block. Not many have known, but actually he made a quiet donation for this, and he also make a donation for the commissioning of the Virgin Mary statue of the church that still stands today. And the church recognized that if you go to the church, there's a plaque that gives recognition that he donated for the statue. So he believes in inclusiveness and religious harmony, racial harmony.